everybody. This is Deborah from Hot Yoga Charlottesville, and we are just going to get really moving today. So I am feeling like I need to be grounded, and I want to connect with the community, and I know that a lot of us are feeling that way. So we're just going to drop right in. So let's get started in Child's Pose.
So right away, start to reach your hands forward. And it's okay if your forehead doesn't reach the mat. We're gonna just take 5 breaths here to settle. So making those breaths really deep. Pushing the hips back, reaching the fingertips forward. Okay, one more big breath in. Sigh it out.
Tuck the toes, downward facing dog.
Right, you can bend and stretch here. Okay, just waking up that backside body. Shoulders drip down the spine. Belly hugs in and up. And we're anchoring down here. Inhale up high on the toes, and then tiptoe your way forward to the front of your mat for ragdoll. So still grounding. Belly and chest on the thighs. You can tuck one pinky finger into the opposite elbow. Shoulders come away from the ears with every exhale, letting the spine just cascade down. One more breath here. Go ahead and release that bind. Toe heel the feet together to touch. Inhale, lift halfway up. Exhale to fold. Inhale, lift half. Exhale, bow. One more time. Inhale, lift half. Bow deep. Inhale, rise. As you exhale, bring the hands to heart center. So ground through the feet, pull the hips up towards the ribs, and give yourself just a moment here. Really push the hands into each other. Feel the corners of the chest engage. And then set an intention. I know for me, it's been really hard to stick it out through the end of these videos, to stay connected, to stay moving. So maybe today that's your goal. Give yourself one more big breath here. Flutter the eyes open. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, bend the knees, bow. Inhale, lift half. Exhale, high plank. Holding here. Firming the belly. Deepening the breath. Big breath in, low plank, inhale up dog, exhale down dog. Inhale high on the toes, drag the gaze forward, step or hop. Inhale half, exhale bow. Inhale rise, Exhale, fold.
Inhale, half. Exhale, low plank. Three breaths here in downward facing dog.
So if you feel rounded in your upper back, give yourself a little bend in your knees and then push your chest back towards your thigh. Inhale to toes.
Bend the knees, gaze forward, feet to hands. Inhale, half. Exhale, bow. Inhale, rise. Exhale, fold. Inhale, half. Flow through your vinyasa. Stepping or hopping back as you're ready.
We'll do one more sun A here. Inhale to toes.
Bend the knees, up or hop. Lift half. Bow deep.
Inhale, rise. Exhale, fold.
Lift half and flow.
Breath in, breath out. Inhale high,
drag the gaze forward, feet to hands, lift half, bow deep. Chair pose.
So sinking the weight back, taking the shoulders down away from the ears and pull the belly in. You can lift up all 10 of your toes, spread them out and place them back down on the mat. Keep the breath moving. Big breath in.
Exhale to fold. Inhale, half. Exhale, flow.
Right leg high.
Step forward, warrior one. Inhale, rise.
We'll be here for 5 breaths. So drag your right hip back in space, shoulders down. Root down through the outside edge of your back foot. And pull your belly in. Focus on your breath. Gaze up, eyes up, reach up.
Exhale, hands to mat, flow through.
Left leg rises.
Step forward, warrior one, inhale.
So right hip forward, left hip back. Keep breathing. Big breath in.
Hands to mat, flow through. Upward facing dog. Downward facing dog.
Breath in. Breath out.
Inhale to toes. Bend the knees, step or hop. Lift half. Bow deep. Right fingertips on the floor. Sit your seat nice and low, and then peel your chest up. Utkatasana. Belly in. Big breath in. Exhale, fold. Inhale, half. Exhale, flow. Right leg rises.
Step forward, warrior one. Inhale here. Pull the belly in, nice and low in the hips. Outer edge of that back foot, really root it down. Shoulders down. Breath in, exhale, bring hands to heart center, and then open yourself up to warrior two. So Squeeze all 10 fingers. Stay nice and low. Last breath in. Exhale, takes hands to mat. Flow through. Left leg rises. Step forward. Warrior one. And then keep going through your adjustments. Right, you guys know what they are. What's going to hold you here? Breath in. Hands come to the heart. And then open up warrior two. Right, feel your triceps turn on. Feel your belly center you here. Last breath in. Take hands to mat. Step left foot back. Low plank. Breath in. Up dog. Breath out. Down dog. Inhale to toes. Bend the knees. Step or hop. Lift half. Bow deep. Chair pose. Big breath in, exhale, fold. Inhale, half, and flow. Right leg rises, step forward, warrior one. Sink lower on the exhale, warrior two, just two breaths. Last breath in. Exhale, brings hands to mat. Flow. Left leg rises, step forward. Inhale, warrior one. Exhale, nice and low. Breath in. Exhale, warrior two. Nice and low, nice and firm. Big breath. Hands to mat, flow through. Toe, heel, the feet together to touch. Inhale, brings right leg back and up. Open, bend, and stretch. Square the shoulders. Flex that foot. Stay here or flip your dog. Last breath in. Exhale, flips you over. Square the right hip down and then ripple yourself forward to high plank. Replace the right foot down. Take the right hand underneath the heart. Open yourself up, side plank. Hips forward, heart up. And then take your variation. Today I'm going to float my left leg and take three elbow touches to knee. In. Out, in, out, one more. Crunch it in, reach it long, hips up. Option, flow through, or press back, downward facing dog. Toe heeling those feet together to touch. Left leg rises, open, bend and stretch. Flex that foot, knees high, shoulders square. Maybe sink that right heel down. Stay or flip your dog. Last big breath in. On the exhale, flip yourself back over. Extend the left leg long, square the hips. Ripple forward. Finding that high plank. And then left hand's going to come down, right hand's going to come up. Hips up. And I'm going to take my elbow to my knee three times. So inhale to reach out. Exhale. exhale, crunch. In, out, in, out. One more time. Out. Hold everything long. And then option to flow. Or just push it back to downward facing dog. Big breath in. Open mouth to exhale. Toe heel those feet together to touch behind you. Bend the knees. Gaze forward. See if you can't kick your heels, your seat with your heels. Breath in and hop. Inhale, half. Exhale, fold. Sink the seat. Chair pose. Hands come to the heart. Breath in. Exhale, twist. Stay here, open your arms. One more breath in. Exhale brings you to chair pose through center. Exhale comes hands to the heart once more and set up your twist the other way. Last breath in, exhale, fold. Separate your feet about 6 inches apart. Grab a hold of your big toes with your peace fingers. Inhale to lift halfway up. And then exhale to bow. Belly and thighs touch. Really deepening the breath. Pulling that belly away from your thighs. Go ahead and release this grip. Walk right onto the palms of your hands for gorilla pose. Shake your head out, yes. Shake your head out, no. Maybe rock the weight a little bit more forward, stretching out the wrists, and then release. So option here to move into crow pose, right? And this is still a pose I'm working on. So what I'm going to do today is just look forward, place my elbows into my knees. That didn't make any sense. Place my knees into my armpits and just lean, right? Like there's something I really want out in front of me, right? About 12 inches. I'm going to lift one leg. I'm going to maybe see if I can lift the other off. Right? Maybe not. It's not a perfect. It's a practice. Three. Two. And one. Low plank. Up dog. And down dog. Big breath in. Big breath out. Right leg rises. Step forward. Inhale, crescent warrior. So both hips in a line. Left leg straight and strong. Hands to the heart. Pivot that upper body forward. Hook the elbow and twist. Squeeze the inner thighs. Deepen the twist by pulling in the belly. Give it two more breaths. Last breath in. On the exhale, open it up to warrior two. Inhale to reverse. Staying low. Feeling this good stretch in the side body. Extended side angle. Shoulders away from the ears. Hips stay nice and low.
Really reaching out with that top arm. Maybe taking it straight up and down and turning the palm behind you and finding a half bind. Maybe reaching towards the floor. Or perhaps out in front of you. Two more breaths. In. Out. Big full breath in. Binds release. Hands to mat. Flow through.
Left leg rises. Step forward. Crescent warrior. Inhale, rise.
Hands to the heart.
Pivot the upper body forward. Big breath in. And then I'm going to use that exhale to leverage my twist. Squeezing thighs. Staying low. Last breath in. Exhale, open it up, warrior two. Inhale, reverse. And then extended side angle. So shoulders away from the ears. And we've got lots of options here. Maybe that hand comes straight up and down. The palm faces behind you and you place the back of the hand in the small of the back. Maybe you reach for that thigh crease. Maybe you reach all the way for the floor or you take that hand out in front of you. Two more breaths in, out. Full inhale, let your binds release and flow through your vinyasa. Eating in downward facing dog. Big breath in. Big breath out. Right leg sweeps high. Step it forward, warrior one. Inhale, rise. Exhale, warrior two. Straighten that front leg and start to reach yourself forward. Finding triangle pose. Find length in your neck, tucking your chin in slightly, pushing your hips forward. Last breath in. Exhale, pulls you to stand. Parallel all 10 toes in the same direction. Big breath in. Exhale, forward fold. Fingertips can come in line with the toes. And then you're going to reach the crown of your head towards the floor. Rocking the weight forward, pulling those kneecaps up off the knees, and reaching for that space. Right, and having that option to stay here in that forward fold, Prasarita, taking the feet above the head, or working another arm balance as you see fit. And if you're up, come on down. Take one more breath in. On the exhale, walk the hands out in front of you. Inhale here, lift halfway up. And I'm gonna wiggle my feet in just a little bit. Take my hands to my hips and slowly rise. Pivoting all 10 toes towards the front of the mat, towards the front of wherever you're facing. Inhale, lift the arms high. And then slowly exhaling. This is a great place for blocks if you have them.
pulling that right hip back in space. Maybe reaching those fingertips a little bit further out. Bending into that front knee, lift halfway up, and then exhale, flow through. Left leg rises, step it forward, warrior one. Inhale. Warrior two. Dragging those heels together, working that front leg nice and straight, and then reaching forward to triangle pose. Hips forward, neck long. One more breath here. Let that sideways pull you to standing. You're going to pivot all 10 toes in the same direction. Interlace the hands behind your low back. Take a full breath in and then bow forward. And you can stay facing that same direction. And I just turned around so you didn't have to stare at my high knee. So you're welcome. Squeeze the palms if you have that bind. Let the shoulders rinse here. Belly keeps pulling in, thighs stay engaged. Weight drops forward. Go ahead and release that bind. Inhale, lift halfway up. And then place the hands on the hips. Come slowly up. Pivot all 10 toes towards the front. So your left foot is going to be forward. Your right foot's going to be back. Arms are up. And then you bow forward over that extended left leg. Just giving yourself a nice stretch in the hamstring and the belly of that muscle. Letting your upper body drape. And come back to the breath. Inhale, bend that knee. Plant the hands. Flow through your vinyasa. Downward facing dog. Go ahead and walk your hands all the way to the back of your mat. You can toe heel the feet together if you want, and slowly rise. Arms up. We're going to take eagle right side. So let the right arm come under the left, and then take the right leg up and over. Elbows rise, seat is low, hands come away from the face. Look straight through your forearms. Hug everything in tight. Breath in. Exhale, sweep the arms. Left under right. Right, move right in. Seat low, legs cross. In, exhale, eagle right side, one more time, move right in, last breath in, exhale, sweep arms high, left side. shoulders back, seat low. Last breath in. Exhale, rise, arms up. We'll work dancer right side. So right hand comes out to the side like you're gonna pick up a tray or serve some food. And then pick up your right foot from the inside, level the knees, and begin. Point the toes, let the chest come down. If you want, you can maybe try taking that left arm all the way towards the floor. And begin to kick yourself out. Cartwheel the arms around. Left side. Get yourself stable and steady and then begin. Right, maybe that hand comes over the heart. Maybe it reaches towards the floor. And as you're ready, kick yourself out. Roll your shoulders up, back and down. Give yourself a breath in. A breath out. Sweep the arms up. Take hands before the heart as you exhale. Step forward on that right leg and pivot the upper body down. Right, finding this warrior three pose. Option to move towards airplane, sweeping the arms back behind you. And then as you're ready, work that right hand down, stack the hips, half moon. Okay, maybe float that bottom hand. And if you fall, just know it's no big deal. Let's get right back to it. Maybe try to take the bind today. Give yourself one more breath. And then fold. Inhale, rise. Hands before the heart. Step forward on that left leg. And take the upper body down and the right leg up. Option to keep those hands pressed. Or to move towards airplane. And then as you're ready, beginning to move towards half moon. Maybe taking that bind. Choosing to stay or to come back if you fall out. And bow deep. Nice work. Inhale, lift half. Exhale, fold in. Inhale, rise. Exhale, bow. Inhale, half. And then make your way to downward facing dog. Meeting in that downward facing dog. Taking a moment, if that's what you need, maybe a cleansing breath, and then inhale, ripple your spine forward to high plank. Taking a full breath in, and then lowering all the way down to your mat.
good rest.
And take your chin forward, bring your toes together to touch, and then you can separate them if you wish. You're going to reach your arms out in front of you like Superman, and then inhale to bring both ends up. So inhale, we're going to reach out, and then exhale, we're going to crunch the elbows in. So inhale, reach, exhale, sweep, in, out, in, out, reach it long, squeeze it in, and hold for 3, 2, and 1. You make a little pillow for your hands, let your forehead rest. And then as you're ready, you're going to take those hands back by your side, chin is forward, squeeze your legs together, and inhale, bring both ends up. So reaching for the feet with the arms, bringing the chest up, really reaching the arms back, take a big breath in. On the exhale, we're going to bend the knees and move right into floor bow. So kick in, heart up, you've got this, choose to stay for 3, 2, and 1. Look off to the right, you can windshield wiper the legs back and forth, and then look off to the left. Chin forward, hands are going to come underneath the shoulder, squeeze your thighs together, place your knees down or tuck your toes up to you, we're going to press ourselves up, coming up into that high plank, holding here, just firming up through the belly, turning on the core. Holding for 3, 2, and 1. Downward facing dog. Big breath in. Big breath out. Inhale up high on the toes. Bend the knees, step up or float yourself through to the seat. Plant the feet, get set up for bridge. If you have that block and you're ready for it, you're welcome to take a restorative bridge at this time. Otherwise, set your feet, set your hands, and press your hips up. Keep the belly in. Let it support your back bend. Chest towards the wall behind you, or whatever's there. Keep the breath moving. Hips up just a little more, and slowly lower down. Take 2 breaths. Inhale, brings the hips up, bridge your wheel. Just being mindful, it's not in the heat like we're used to, so just move with caution wherever you choose to go. Hips up a little more. And slowly lower it down. 2 breaths in, out. One more time in, one more time out. Bridge or wheel, take it up.
exhale, you lower. We're gonna come up just one more time. So get ready for it. Make your choice, bridge or wheel. Know you can always change your mind. And up you go. Knees in, belly squeezes, heart up. We're here for 5 breaths. Last breath in. And you lower down. Supta Baddha Konasana. Soles of the feet together. Let the knees open wide. I like to take the backs of my hands to my rib cage after a wheel. Just stretching the wrists. Shoulders, let them drip down the spine. Right? Tucked underneath you. And then let your hands gently close your knees and hug them into your chest. Go ahead and rock side to side. And then as you're ready, happy laughing baby. Low belly pulls in. Feel really grounded here, that your whole spine is touching the floor. You're working the strength of your core to push your tailbone down towards the floor. You're pulling down with the arms, but keeping the arms integrated, and then pushing back with the feet to really get into your hips. Last breath in. Hug the knees into the chest. We're gonna do just a little bit of core work here. We'll work some 30, 60, 90s. So you're welcome to take your hands under your seat if that feels good, or they can just reach down long. So you're gonna flex the feet really straight. Take a full breath in, and then lower 30 degrees. Hold for the in. Hold for the out. And then lower 30 more. Breath in. Keep your low back plastered into the floor. Breath out. And then to a hover. Reach for your feet. Pull your belly in. Last breath in. Exhale, upper body lowers. Feet come up. Find a little V with your feet so your heels are together, your toes are apart. Breath in. Lower 30. Breath in. Lower 30. Belly down. It's hard for me too. Breath in. To a hover, reach for your heels. Hold for 3. Hold for 2. And 1. Upper body down, legs up. And then make a tiki with your feet. So toes together, heels apart. Right, really focus here. If you need to place a hand on your belly, then remember to push it down. Do it. Take a breath in. Lower 30. Breath in. Lower 30. Belly down. Breath in. To a hover. Reaching here. You're doing great. Keep it up. Hold for 3. 2. And 1, upper body down. Hug the knees in, rock side to side, just for a moment. Squeezing everything tight. And we have just a couple minutes to go upside down. If you have a wall beside you, you're welcome to take your legs up the wall. Otherwise, if you have a block, you can place it underneath your sacrum. Let the legs come up into the air. today. Just a couple more breaths. Gently begin to float the legs down. Pick up the feet enough to remove the block, and then hug the knees into the chest. Go ahead and change the grip to behind the thighs. We're going to rock and roll just 3 or 4 times. And then as you're ready, cross the ankles, roll over the feet, downward facing dog. Just giving yourself a moment to reset. And then as you're ready, take the right leg back and up. We're going to make our way to resting half pigeon. Know that 4 on the floor is here for you as an alternative pose. Go ahead and find a nice long spine and then walk yourself forward. With every exhale, see what you can let go here. Maybe unclenching your jaw. One more breath in. And then slowly begin to walk yourself up, rolling onto that right hip, sweeping the left leg around for full pigeon. So flexing the feet. And this is about the level of my flexibility today. I'm just going to be here with this, taking a breath in and a breath out. One more breath in. On the exhale, I'm going to pick that left foot up, set it out in front, and sweep my right leg back to come over to resting half pigeon on the other side. This pose has been really challenging for me lately, just personally. So know that you're not alone if this is hard for you. Right? And you're always welcome to take that 4 on the floor. We're not going to be here very long today. I'm going to try to come off my elbows and really relax for 2 more breaths. Walking myself up, coming back onto that left hip. I'm going to sweep my right leg around and take that full pigeon over on this side. If you've got a lot of space, you're welcome to take the block here or out in front of the left leg and place the right foot on it. Right, just 1 more breath in. 1 more breath out. I'm going to take both my legs long. And just shake them out a little bit. I like to take the heels of my hands and just run them down the lines of my thighs, maybe down the calves. It can feel really good. You can just shake out the knees in any way you wish. And then as you're ready, flex the feet, take the arms up, and then exhale, forward fold. Just reaching for whatever you can reach. And whatever that is, it's the right thing. You can take this as a restorative forward fold or something a little bit more active. So whatever works for you today in this moment, that's the thing that I want you to try and do. Give yourself 1 more breath in and then walk yourself up, planting the feet and rolling all the way down to your mat. When you get there, hug your knees in. just let everything go. Let your toes fall out, your heels roll in. Your belly just gently rise and fall. Feel invited to stay in the Savasana as long as you have, as long as your day allows. As you're ready, you can take a few deeper breaths. Then roll to a side that's comfortable to you. Pausing for just a moment here. And finally, pushing yourself up to a final seat, meeting with that nice long spine. Taking the hands before.